channel. My name is Payton Ackerman and this is Pay Takes LA. I am super excited because I wanted to have my own channel for a while now, so thank you so much for watching. And if you don't know who I am, a little bit of background about myself is I am 20 years old. I'm originally from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, but after I graduated high school, I moved to Los Angeles, California, the City of Angels, to pursue my dreams of becoming a professional dancer. So I sent out a few weeks ago on my Instagram for you guys to send me questions that you think you would want to have the answers to, because I thought no better way to have a first video than a Q&A vlog. If you don't follow me on Instagram and Twitter, I'm going to tag them below, so make sure you go do that. My Instagram is PAYYYTON Ackerman, one word, and then my Twitter is PAYYYTON03. So to get started, the first question is from or.edits, and they said, if you could have a different name, what would it be? I love names that can be both boys and girls' names, kind of like my name. And I always said, if I ever have a little girl when I'm older, I will name her Carter Ray. So I would say Carter. My next question is from Rach Bozeman 2, and she said, what made you start dancing? So I actually started dancing really young. I was 3 years old once I was potty trained. Both my parents put me in it. And I think it was because I have an older sister, Taylor. She's 4 years older than me, and that's what she did. And I think they were just like, oh, maybe we'll try her out and it, see what happens. And I ended up loving it and sticking with it. And now it's what I'm doing with my life. So my parents started me in it. My next question is from Megan underscore Ross. And Megan said, where do you see yourself in 10 years? So I am 20 years old now. In 10 years, I would hope that I am settling down, getting married or already married, starting my family, and I will probably be in a different state. I want to try something completely different than LA eventually, like once I'm done dancing professionally and want to like settle down and just teach dance. I want to try maybe going back to Pittsburgh or somewhere that has like lots of land and not a lot around it, just because I think it would be cool to say that I came from Pittsburgh where there's stuff to do 20 minutes away and then you can go into the quiet, and then moving to LA where it's totally populated and so much to do, and then maybe going somewhere where there's like nothing to do and your closest neighbor is 20 minutes away. So I think that's where I will be in 10 years. My next question is from Sabin Elk, and they said, how did you and your boyfriend meet and how long have you been dating? So if you follow me on my social media or you know me personally, you know that I have a boyfriend named Logan Stork, and we have been dating almost seven years. So 14 years old, we started our freshman year of high school. Crazy young, don't know why my parents allowed it, but they did. But I think it's because I have known Logan since I was itty bitty in kindergarten, because his dad actually coached him and my brother and his brother, because they all played hockey. So we have known each other pretty much since we could walk. My next question is from Lauren Barnes, and she said, how do you feel about how Dance Moms portrayed you? So I was on a television show growing up in high school called Dance Moms. It's a reality television show. And I was on it a few episodes for about 4 seasons long. I enjoyed being on it. I thought it was a great opportunity and it was super cool because not everyone can say they were on a television show that succeeded as much as Dance Moms did. However, I think that they portrayed me and my mom in a light that we, in a way that we aren't. And it kind of hurt because people believe reality TV and think that that's who I really am, because I seemed so hard and so mean, but I really am not that way. And people that end up meeting me after are like, oh, I get it, it's a reality TV show. But if you watch Keeping Up with the Kardashians or Teen Mom or Jersey Shore or even Dance Moms, like there always is someone to stir the pot. Even like on The Bachelorette, there's always one girl or one guy. And that's unfortunately what my character was and my role was. So I wish that they would have portrayed me in a different way. My next question is from Kata.Bosselman, and she said, what's your favorite makeup product? So clearly I don't wear a lot of makeup. I do like to do it though, and I didn't wear a lot of makeup in high school. So if you would have asked me in high school, I would say mascara. But now I would say Bare Minerals concealer, because my dark circles are so bad. I could wake up after having, I'm not exaggerating, 12 hours of sleep, and my dark circles are all the way around my eyes. So if you are a dancer or you're constantly sweating and you're exercising and you want makeup that doesn't like cake or wear off or just looks bad, I would say Bare Minerals is a really good product, especially for under their eyes. My next question is from KushinKR underscore art, and they said, what is your biggest fear? If you know me, you know that I'm petrified of water. Swimming, I don't know how to swim. I mean, I could doggy paddle, but like balancing on my back and like treading water, I can't do. And I got out of it in high school because I was so terrified of water. Like anytime I fly over the ocean when I'm flying home or like something like that is just really scary. So water is my biggest fear. Weird. My next question is from Mia_S123. And Mia said, what is your favorite Netflix series? I'm obsessed with Netflix. I think it's one of the best inventions ever. And I'm currently watching Grey's Anatomy, which I really do like. However, just a little long for me. My favorite would probably be a tie between One Tree Hill and Friday Night Lights, the TV series, not the movie. I know that they're not on Netflix now because Netflix changes what's on and what's off, but I watched it in high school and they're both super similar. I do know they're on Hulu, so if you have Hulu, go watch them. They're awesome for like the age range of high school to out of high school and college, which is what I'm still in. My next question is from Derek Photographies. And he said, how long have you been dancing and what is your favorite style? So I'm about to be 21 and I have been dancing since I was 3. And my favorite style is hip hop. I think it's because I was never super technical growing up. Whereas like lyrical and contemporary and ballet, I was trained in everything and I enjoyed it. But hip hop was so fun to me because there wasn't a right and wrong way. I could do something different and people would be like, oh my gosh, that's so cool. Whereas if you were to hold your leg this way and lyrical, that's wrong. If you hold it this way, it's right. So I think hip hop is my favorite. Also, if you follow me on Instagram, you'll see a bunch of my dance videos. My next question is from Leah_Stefano06. And she said, what's your everyday morning routine? So I just got a new puppy. His name is Winston and he is the cutest dog ever. So when I wake up every morning, I pick him up out of my bed. I walk him to make sure he goes to the bathroom and then I feed him. And then after I take care of him is when I start to like brush my teeth and get ready for my day. Once I'm ready, I'm either going to work, an audition, or dance class. So it's pretty much taking care of my puppy first and then worrying about myself. My next question is from Olivia_194. And Olivia said, how has your life changed after Dance Moms? So it has changed crazy. I have graduated high school, moved across the country from my family and everything I've ever known. I have been living on my own for a little over 2 years now, supporting myself. My boyfriend lives here with me now, and I have my own dog. So I am pretty much an adult, whereas in high school, when I was on Dance Moms, I was just figuring out what kind of human I wanted to be, what I wanted to do with my life. So I'm really happy with this point in my life, and yeah. My next question is from Carly_Mendez1998, the year after I was born. And she said, what's your favorite TV show? Okay, this is my favorite question. I am obsessed with the Teen Mom series. Teen Mom OG, Teen Mom 2, 16 and Pregnant, Teen Mom, 16 and, or Teen Mom Young and Pregnant. Like, I'm literally obsessed. I record their series, I read their books, I buy their clothing brands, like I'm not exaggerating. I even go to the live tapings of the reunion special. I have an autographed rubber ducky from one of them. It's the best TV show ever. And I feel like everyone has that one reality TV show that they love, of course, and that's mine. So if you don't watch it, you have to go watch it, trust me. My next question is from Yana De Jesus, and she said, what would you say drives you to dance? I would say my parents, just because they gave so much time, effort, and money towards me being happy and doing what I love to do, that it makes me want it even more. So I moved out here and everyone out here is incredible and everyone out here wants the same thing and has the same feelings. But when I go to an audition for an artist and there's 1,000 girls and they're looking for one or two girls, why can't that girl be me? And I think that, so I'm like, you know what? I'm gonna fight, I'm gonna push. And I think that's what puts that fire under me to want to do this and never give up. So I would say my passion behind dance is my mom and dad. My next question is from SamCart2, and they said, if you could play any professional sport, what would it be? I know it's crazy, well, not crazy, but not common for girls to play hockey, ice hockey, but I'm obsessed with it because my brother played it all of his life, my boyfriend played it all his life, and I'm from Pittsburgh, so go Pittsburgh Pens, the best team ever. So I grew up around hockey, so I would probably say ice hockey. It's a really good sport. My next question is from Izzy Ervezes, and she said, what is your favorite food? If you asked me this before I moved to LA, I'd probably say steak or mac and cheese. Now that I live in California, sushi all the way. I'm obsessed with sushi. It's bad though, because you're not supposed to eat it a lot, and I eat it way too much. Like, way too much. But it's so good. So sushi. My next question is from Jenna_E11. And she said, how did you get abs? So it's gonna sound crazy, but I have had abs since I was a little girl. And yes, dance has definitely helped like maintain them and have them, but I'm not super big on working out. So I think it's just because I have thin skin and I was always exercising growing up, being in dance class. So no tricks there, I'm sorry. I'm just lucky, I guess, but I mean, dancing and staying healthy and keeping my food is what does it. My next question is from Nazar Klee, and they said, when did you start dancing at the ALDC? So I went to a dance studio before I went to Abby's, and then once I went to Abby's, I was 11 turning 12, and I graduated from there. So I was 18 when I graduated. My next question is from Gabby_Gondam, and they said, what is your favorite thing about your career? My favorite thing is that everyone out here wants it just as bad as I do, and I love that because we share such a passion. I also love that we get to do things that not everyone gets to do. So I get to be on TV if I book a job. I get to tour with an artist. I get to do something that I love every day, because for me, I could never sit in like a cubicle and write on and type on a computer. So I get to do something that I enjoy every day in my life and train and work hard for, and that's my favorite thing. My last question is from Emily Chinthagada, and she said, what do you do in your free time? So now that I have a puppy, I play with him all the time. I hang out with my boyfriend now that he lives here, which is so much fun because I did long distance for 2.5 years with him, which was the worst because I just wanted to be with him. And I work just to support myself and be out here. And so that's it for my questions. Thank you guys for sending them, but I also wanted to do five fun facts about me that some of you might not know. My first fun fact is that I love country music. It's my radio station in my car does not change from country. I'm obsessed. I love every single country artist, and I wish that people out in LA liked it more. My second fun fact is my dream artist to dance for is Justin Timberlake. He's an incredible singer, actor, and dancer, so I think that would be awesome. Also, his dancers are the best of the best. My third fun fact is I have a corgi named Winston that I mentioned earlier. My fourth is that I'm the youngest of three children. I have an older sister, Taylor, she just turned 25, an older brother, Connor, he's 23, and I am Payton, I'm about to be 21. My last fun fact is that I adore little kids and animals. So I've always wanted to be a mom, obviously, in a few years when I'm older, and I'm obsessed with all animals. I mean, if I could, I would have 10 dogs and 10 cats and 10 chinchillas and all of that good stuff. So those are my five fun facts. Thank you guys so much for watching my first YouTube video. Please subscribe, comment down below what you want to see next. Hit the bell so you know when I post. And thank you guys so much. Don't forget to follow me on my social medias. I'll be posting them below. Bye guys.